Hi, my name is Dean Smith, and in this Bible vlog, I ask the all-important question, why did Sir Isaac Newton predict the world would end in 2060 AD? Now, most of us are probably familiar with Sir Isaac Newton. He was a renowned scientist in the Middle Ages. He died around 1727 AD, and he's probably most famous for his discovery of gravity. As the story goes, he was sitting under a tree and apparently an apple fell from the tree, hitting him on the head. Now, the actual story goes like this. He was sitting in a garden and he saw an apple fall from the tree and he asked himself this question, why didn't it fall sideways? And as a result of this, he came up with the idea of gravity, that the earth was exerting a force of gravity that was pulling things towards it. And he also believed that other planets, moons, suns also had gravity, and these were having a profound impact as well, and because of their size, they were actually affecting the orbits of planets and moons in the solar system. This radically transformed their understanding of astronomy. And what many people don't realize is that Sir Isaac Newton was also a Christian, and he had an avid interest in end times theology. So why did he predict that the world would end in 2060 AD? To understand why, we need to take a look at an interesting incident that took place in 2011. If you were driving around the US in 2011, you may have seen a billboard proclaiming that the end of the world was going to take place on May 21st, 2011. It was a part of an elaborate $5 million campaign sparked by Family Radio, a broadcast ministry out of California. Harold Camping, its founder and president, had come up with a theory that the rapture would take place on May 21st, 2011, followed by the judgment of God and the apocalypse. Of course, when that didn't take place as he predicted, he grabbed his calculator, did some more calculations, and came to the conclusion that he made some small errors and that the rapture would actually take place on October 21st. But there was a small footnote that May 21st was still valid because it was the start of spiritual judgment. Of course, it didn't take place on October 21st, and the mockery started. Christian Bible teachers were equally shocked by Camping's prediction and quickly pointed to Matthew 20, verse 36, where Jesus said that even he did not know the day of his return. And the word day, the Greek word hamera, refers to a 24-hour day, so Christ was saying that only God in heaven knows the actual day of Christ's second coming. Camping would later recant of this and actually declare that his prediction was a sin. So what is the connection between Sir Isaac Newton and Harold Camping's prediction? Well, to put it simply, Sir Isaac Newton lived in interesting times. Just two centuries earlier, in 1517, Martin Luther had pounded his 95 theses on the door of the All Saints Church in Wittenberg, Germany. He was calling for massive reforms in what was then a very corrupt Roman Catholic Church. The church refused to be reformed and began to persecute Martin Luther, and as a result, he formed the Protest or Protestant Church. In the centuries that followed, the Roman Catholic Church began to aggressively persecute the Protestants, who in return began to look upon the Pope as the Antichrist and the Roman Catholic Church as the War of Babylon mentioned in the book of Revelation. And for those who don't know, the War of Babylon is the mother of all evil. Because of this increased interest in the end times, of course, people began to pop up predicting that Christ's second coming was imminent, and of course they began to predict dates and days when it would happen. Sir Isaac Newton decided to study the end times because he wanted to put an end to all that nonsense. Newton wrote,
"This I mention not to assert when the time of the end shall be, but to put a stop to the rash conjectures of fanciful men who are frequently predicting the time of the end, and by doing so bring the sacred prophecies into discredit, as often their predictions fail."
You see, in his study of the end times, Sir Isaac Newton wrote books and compiled thousands of pages notes. Over 1 million words were written. And these, oddly enough, were donated to the nation of Israel, who then handed them over to the University of Jerusalem for further study. As the Jewish researchers pored through Newton's notes, they found a letter dated to 1704, where Martin Luther stated that he believed that the second coming of Christ would happen around 2060 AD, in other words, in our century. So how did Sir Isaac Newton come to this conclusion? First, though Israel did not exist as a nation in Newton's day, he believed it was necessary for Israel to be restored as a nation before the second coming of Christ. In his commentary on the book of Revelation, Newton said,
"The ruin of the wicked nations, the end of weeping and of all troubles, the return of the Jews from captivity, and their setting up of a flourishing and everlasting kingdom."
Other Bible teachers in Newton's day agreed that Israel needed to be restored as a nation before Christ's second coming, but they were predicting it was going to be imminent sometime in the 17th or even the 18th century. So how did Newton arrive at the 2060 AD date? In the book of Revelation, it speaks of a period of 1,260 days when God would protect the church from satanic attack. But at the end of this period, Satan would be unleashed. He would start a horrific persecution of the church and then try to set up a one-world government through the Antichrist. But in the end, Jesus would return and the world would be judged. But instead of looking upon these as 1,260 days, Newton thought it referred to 1,260 years. So he had the length of time when the church would be protected, but now he needed a start date, and for that he used the formation of the Holy Roman Empire in 800 AD by Charlemagne, who was a very devout Catholic. Because this marked a merging together of the Pope's spiritual supremacy with the political supremacy of Charlemagne. So the question we need to ask ourselves, are there any passages that might support this? Maybe. Big maybe. Many today believe that the restoration of Israel as a nation on May 14, 1948 is a key marker for Christ's return, and that Jesus will return within a generation of that restoration, according to Mark 13, verse 30. So how long is a generation? Well, there have been several figures thrown out. 30 years, 50 years, 70 years. But in Genesis chapter 6, when God says he's going to judge the world with a flood, there's embedded a second judgment that hasn't got much play. As part of the flood judgment, God said he was going to limit man's lifespan to 120 years. Now, if this is a generation from God's perspective, when we add 120 years to 1948, we see it will happen no later than 2068 AD. And this certainly falls within spitting range of Newton's prediction, because based on his study, Newton did not believe that Christ's return would take place any sooner than 2060 AD, but added that it could happen later. But again, this is all just speculation, because only the Father in heaven knows the exact day of Christ's return.